They have now come with their conclusions. They studied the arcades. Now, these arcades, they found had a lot of problems. First of all, they are enclosed. Secondly, they have got corridors between, I don't know between what and what, between, I think, different subunits. Those corridors are called Ibikubo. Now, you had people sitting in the Ibikubo, in the corridors, people were sitting there. You had people, too many people sitting inside one shop, sitting on the veranda, sitting on the steps, sitting on the roadsides, in front of the of these arcades. So these scientists have now studied this and produced a report. And we have now decided, on the advice of the scientists, that we can open these arcades. Some of the arcades, not all, provided they have the following. Number one, temperature guns. These are things which measure people's overnome subject, whether you have got a fever. Social distancing. Tonsenberry must be observed. Hand washing. No traders, no people in the corridors in the Bikubo. No people there. A corridor is a corridor, it's not a shop, it's not. No traders on the verandas. No traders on the steps or the roadsides. They must also keep records. Everybody who buys there must be recorded. You were Museveni, ID card number this, of Rwaitura, or Nakasero, whichever you address you want. Why do we need this record must be in the book? And why do we need the record? In case you get sick, you, the shop fellow, the shop seller, we need to know which people you have interacted with so that we can follow them up. That's why we need a record. The shoppers also must social distance. The sellers, social distance. Inside, abakora mu duka ezo, but no, we no question. This is the Nyankore one for being apart. But also the shoppers, what I mean shop, they must have social distance. They don't come to no. You arrange them. They come. No air conditioning. No air conditioning. Because air conditioning is what causes problems in Europe and the US, that they are advanced. That advancement that does not respect nature is part of the problem. I never use air conditioning. I think the air conditioning in your government house in Entebbe, I switched it off long ago. So that air conditioning is very dangerous because it is the one which is circulating the virus. Everybody must put on masks. everybody, the shop assistants, the shoppers, must all put on masks. Enough toilets. If you have gotten a kid which does not have enough toilets, we shall close it permanently. Because there's no reason why you should create a disease causing unit in the town here. If you are looking for money, then look for the money safely. And I don't know how whether they resolve even the issue of paying for going to the toilet. I don't know whether that has come up, because that was a big issue at one time. Now, apparently, in Kampala, there have been 230 arcades. Well, these arcades, I wanted to find out what they sell. What do these arcades sell? Whose products do they sell? I was told at one time they were selling Chinese products. That's their job. Their job was to make us a market of China. Those are arcades. And Kasita group, Kasita, this sector. Their job, their historical mission, is to make that sure that Uganda is a market of China, the market of India, the market of Dubai. So anyway, those arcades, apparently in Kampala there are 230. 171 have been inspected. Only 110 are compliant. And those are the ones that will be allowed to open. The others must fulfill the requirements. Then we come to the saloons. Our grandchildren is garages for hair. Mine is all right, it doesn't need. Mine is handled by Mama. Mama just. But the other day, I was actually worried about saloons. Saloons, how do you manage to keep people from infecting one another with saloons? But the other day I spoke to one of the saloon people, Mrs. Masoro. Apparently she's the wife of one of our people. And she educated me. She said, don't worry, we shall be like doctors in the hospital. Aren't your doctors treating corona people? I said, yes. How are they doing it? They dress up, they put on gloves, they put on masks. I said, but the masks are not foolproof. The lawyer, the breath can get out of many of these masks. So he said, no, we shall add what they call face shield. Oh, so it will be like, she told me, it will be like a dentist. Dentists are attending to people's teeth safely. I said, okay, if you can protect yourself and protect the client, that's wonderful. Then my next question to her was, but how about the clients? Because you have protected yourself, against the client, and the client is protected because the client is also putting on a face mask. The client is putting on a face mask. We are putting on a face mask and a shield. But then between the client and the client, the social distancing. So I was happy to see that there could be an answer to that. So therefore, we are also going to open the saloons, provided they ensure masks for everybody and face shields for the operators, the surgeons. Because it is also science, I don't know what they do with the hair to take it from Africa to India. It's quite a science. So they will put on face shields. They will then there will be temperature guns to check the temperature of everybody who comes in. Social distancing for the operators. So those specialists in hair science, they will have to have, if you have got a number of them, they have distance between themselves. And then the clients also have distance between themselves. No air conditioning. Just natural airing. In the towns, you may even have to have partitioning in the towns, but in the rural areas, they may not have so many clients. So you can have some variations. Hand washing, etc. So the Minister of Health will work out SOPs for these saloons, so that they can open safely. Now, borders, I was really worried about borders. And even today I was meeting some of my borders, I was not sure that we could find a solution. Because the border, these are two people. Some people even put three. How will you ensure that the other one doesn't affect the other one? But your scientists have come up with a solution when Jen reported to me in the afternoon. He said, no, we have found a solution. What is the solution? He said, don't worry. The rider is already putting on a mask. But a mask, the warrior can go through, and because I normally see this warrior when I put it on, when I have my spectacles, I see mist forming, you know, my spectacles. My spectacles don't see properly. But now, apparently, what we had not zeroed on was that in addition to the mask, the border fellow will put on a helmet. And the helmet is really covering the face and enclosing the mask inside. Oh, so okay. And then this other one behind is having a mask. So they said it was all right. That's what you told me. So, since it is they now think, no, but you must also have a records book. The border must record everybody he transports. Or border alino kuandika buli musabaze yena gwasabaza okwita okusabaza. Alina okuwandiika erinnya lye, essimu ye, endangamuntu ye. Why? In case if the border border tests get sick, want to know how many people he was in contact with, and we go for them. So we need this record. But the border border fellows also now need to be organized. To be in one place? No, so they must be, the Minister of Transport is going to give them stages where they can work from. So therefore, the border borders will open on the 27th of July. The others, the saloons, the arcades, it is immediate from tomorrow.